Welcome to Quirky French Podcast, the podcast that helps you speak more confidently, feel more focused, and be more in control of your French learning journey. Prêt? C'est parti! Salut tout le monde! Welcome to Quirky French Podcast. I'm Naima, and this is episode number 2. Let's go! So in today's episode, we'll talk about our bête noire. We'll talk about the fear of speaking French. And in this episode, I'm going to go through some key principles, some key ideas about the work that's needed to get rid of your fear. And I'm also going to talk about why trying to get rid of your fear too early can kind of hurt your learning. And then, yeah, we'll just start to explore your fear in more detail. I'll show you that you may have been focusing on the wrong thing the whole time. Okay, then let's start. First of all, I want to get a few things straight. Number one, you can and you will get over the fear. You know, it doesn't matter how anxious you've been. It doesn't matter how long you've had that anxiety. It doesn't even matter what your level in French is or the number of years that you've been learning French. So you can get rid of it. You will get over the fear. However, it's probably not going to be what you expect. So, you know, you need to keep an open mind and bear with me as you experience that transformation. Number two, it's a marathon, not a race. It's going to take time. It's going to take practice. It's going to take falling and getting up again, testing things out, figuring things out, experimenting. It's really about that journey. And, you know, the journey is going to be more important and more rewarding in the end, you know, than the end results, namely not being scared. Number three, I want to invite you to get familiar with your fear, to sit in the fear, sit within the fear, before you try to get rid of it. You know, if you look up on the internet, there's tons of resources on how to get rid of your fear in 5 easy steps, 5 tricks to get rid of your fear, blah, blah, blah. Well, I really want to invite you to reconsider and to try and learn more about who you are right now with that fear and to learn to deal with the fear of speaking before you try to get over it and try to get rid of it. And you know, for some of you, learning about yourself and leaning into that fear, learning about this experience of fear is going to be enough. You won't even care so much about trying to get rid of it. But regardless, that's already part of the end result. If the fear is still here, but it's not overwhelming, you know, then it's already a success in itself. Number four. The other reason you should study your fear is because fear is not just a negative emotion or a nuisance. It's also a message. It's also there to tell you something and to teach you something about yourself. And so before you try to get rid of that fear, you need to lean in, pay attention, and listen to what the fear is trying to tell you, to teach you. So long story short, we'll explore the topic, but I'm not going to try and tell you how to get rid of, you know, the fear just yet. It's not what I'm going to be focusing on right now. Instead, I just want to invite you on that journey with me. And you'll see, things will get interesting. And that's the whole point. We'll explore the fear, we'll see what it can bring out of you, the good thing that it can bring out of you and out of your friends. You know, I also want to point out something important. Trying to get rid of that fear too soon, at best, isn't helpful. It's not really going to do you any good. And at worst, it can kind of hinder your learning. So what do I mean by that? First of all, fear is not necessarily bad. It can also bring something good out of you, as I said earlier. But so far, your fear has kind of been holding you back in your learning journey. But that very same fear can be used to serve you. So let's explore it, you know, let's play with it a little bit before we try to get rid of it too early. If you try to get rid of that fear without paying attention to what it's telling you, your fear is basically going to be replaced by something else that's going to be problematic and something else that's going to prevent you from becoming fluent. And actually, I'm sure that if you're listening to my podcast, you may have looked up tips on the internet to get over your fear of speaking, and you've noticed that they don't really work. And it's because you need to learn about your fear first. So until you learn about this, until you study yourself, and until you learn to deal with your fear, I wouldn't suggest that you try to get rid of it too early. Okay, so let's do it. Let's talk about the fear then. Well, to tell you a little bit about my experience when I came to the UK, I was overwhelmed. I'd studied English at university, but it was the Queen's English. And when I moved, I moved over to the northeast of England, and the accent was totally different. I was so disorientated, to say the least. I couldn't understand a word, and it was really hard. It was hard because I couldn't connect with people, and it was hard on my ego as well. You know, I was educated, I knew English, and I was doing well at uni, and what was happening to me, you know, all of those things that, you know, I had in my mind, and all of that disappointment and pressure I was carrying. And weirdly, the more I was trying to figure out how to speak and connect to people, the more I was living in my head and not actually connecting with people. And then the times that I could converse with them, it was draining so much energy out of me that I couldn't really be myself. I couldn't relate to them, and they couldn't really get to know me. And yeah, it was really hard. I actually cried a lot on my first year. I would get home after work and I would just cry because I was tired and lonely and overwhelmed. So, you know, I had to unlearn a lot. I had to unlearn what I'd learned at uni. And I had to unlearn this unhelpful way of thinking. I had to let go of that pressure I had put on myself. And also I had to find other ways to get by and connect with people. And on top of that, because, you know, I've got anxiety, it was hard for me to make friends and to get along with colleagues when I got my first job. So, yeah, it was a real challenge. So I've been there, guys. And then as a language coach, usually when learners are asked about their anxiety, you know, speaking is the number one thing. That's what triggers the most anxiety for learners. And then comes listening. But speaking really is the main thing. It's really about the conversation and interacting with people. It does happen to some degree with writing and reading. But I think it's that live situation where you're actually in front of someone. You know, that's the moment where people get the most nervous. And, you know, most of the feedback that I get from learners is not so much that they're scared of speaking. It's not how they will be phrasing it. But it's going to be something like the fear of being perceived negatively. They don't want to, you know, sound stupid. Or the fear of performing poorly. You know, they don't really want to make mistakes. They're scared of making mistakes. They want to speak very well the first time. Or, you know, it's going to be a fear that they won't understand the other person, or they won't know how to get their point across. So you need to become aware that your fear and that fear of engaging in conversation is not the actual real issue. There's actually something else. It's like an underlying fear that causes you to not want to engage in speaking. And I want you to explore that. So that's my first question for you guys. What really scares you? There's the fear of speaking French, but that fear is actually caused by another fear. Okay, so take a moment to think about it. It could be crystal clear. Maybe you already understand that deeper issue, but perhaps you didn't even know that it actually is simply a symptom of another fear. And there's something else at play here, basically. So ask yourself the question, why am I scared? What is it about speaking that causes me to feel scared? You know, if you're not sure, have a look at the worksheet. You can download the worksheet with this podcast episode and take some time to explore. If you feel unsure, next time you engage in a conversation, Pay attention to your thoughts and what went through your mind as you were having that conversation. And actually, it's the same process. If speaking is so daunting to you that you avoid conversations altogether, do the same thing. You know, when you think about having a conversation, what pops through your mind that makes you decide not to actually start up a conversation? What are the thoughts that you have in your mind? So yeah, have a look at the worksheet and complete the sentence. I'm scared of having a conversation because I'm scared of... complete the statement. So yeah, in today's episode, I don't have any solution to offer. I just wanted to introduce the idea that the fear will be addressed, but it's not the real issue. And because it's not the real issue, it shouldn't be your main focus. Your fear is just a symptom of something else that needs addressing, and we'll get to the bottom of that too. In the future, you're going to learn how to use your fear in a way that propels you in the right direction instead of paralyzing you or holding you back. And again, if you've tried things in the past and they didn't work, let me reassure you, there's nothing wrong with you, so don't let past attempts discourage you. It simply means that the techniques you've tried in the past were not addressing the root cause of your fear. And again, if I'm going to use a medical analogy, imagine you've got a cough. You can take medication to shut off the symptoms, so you're not going to have a painful throat temporarily, but you know, you'll still have a cold. So it's the same with your friends. If you want to overcome your nerves, you need to move past the symptoms and you really need to tackle the root cause at its core. So let me plug my coaching program now. I want to share with you that you can register for coaching with me and we'll dive deep, we'll explore your fear and we'll observe how it's holding you back and how it creeps in various ways in your learning. You know, you're going to learn to identify and recognize your fear, because sometimes the problem is that if it's been driving and controlling you that whole time, you may not even realize how sneaky it can be. And you may not even see that you've been studying French in a way that doesn't really serve you. But that's just one area of the work you'll do with me. We'll also take your French to the next level in so many other ways. You know where to find me. Just head on to my website, quirkyfrench.com, and enroll for coaching. So that's it for me. That's enough for me. And that's episode 2. Again, if you like the sound of this podcast, you can like, you can subscribe and comment. And it was really great getting feedback from you in the previous episode. So thank you very much. And let's continue to grow and support each other. And remember that you can head on to my website, quirkyfrench.com, where you can access exclusive content and join my free weekly coaching sessions. You can discuss with me live, you can ask questions and get support and practice your French. And did I say it was free? So take a moment to reflect and let me know. Have you figured out what causes you to be scared of speaking? Let me know in the comments and I'll speak to you next week. Keep learning, keep growing, and keep it quirky. À bientôt et à la semaine prochaine. Salut!